弟兄姊妹和朋友们，下午好。
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters.
今天我们聚集在这里一起信仰我们所爱的弟兄 Steve Bass.
We're gathered here today to remember our beloved brother Steve Bass.
Steve 弟兄生于1951年8月22日，于2024年6月22日在家中安详去世，享年。
Brother Steve was born on August 22nd, 1951. He passed away peacefully at home on June 22nd, 2024, at the age of 72 years and 10 months.
他曾经是一名焊接技工，从罗福克海军造船厂退休。他一生居住于弗吉尼亚州普茨茅斯市。
He worked as a welder who retired from the Norfolk Naval Shipyard and lived his whole life in Portsmouth, Virginia.
Steve 弟兄是一位美国原住民，是南塞蒙德印第安部落的成员。他曾经担任部落议员，全力的支持服务于部落的事务。
Steve was a proud Native American and member of the Nansemond Indian Nation.He served as a tribal councilman and served faithfully to support the tribe.
Steve 弟兄喜欢户外活动，是一个很好的猎人和天才的园丁。
He loved the outdoors and was a good hunter and a gifted gardener.
Steve 弟兄的遗书包括妻子桂大河、在新西兰的妓女张毅、姐姐 Elizabeth、哥哥 Samuel 和弟弟 Earl Bass。
Steve is survived by his wife, Dacha Bass, his stepdaughter, Yi Zhang of New Zealand, his sister, Elizabeth Ann Bass of Glasgow, Virginia, brother, Samuel M. Bass of Suffolk, Virginia, and brother, Earl L. Bass of South Mills, North Carolina.
下面是读经的时间，今天读经的内容是在诗篇23篇。
Next, we have our scripture reading, which is from Psalm 23.
请所有会众起立。
Please stand.
诗篇23篇。耶和华是我的牧者，我必不致缺乏。他使我躺卧在青草地上，领我在可安歇的水边。他使我的灵魂苏醒，为自己的名引导我走义路。我虽行过深的幽谷，也不怕遭害，因为你与我同在。你的杖、你的竿都安慰我，在我敌人面前，你为我摆设筵席，你用油膏了我的头，使我的福杯满溢。我一生一世必有恩惠慈爱随着我，我且要住在耶和华的殿中，直到永远。
Psalm 23, The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures.He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil.My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Amen. 感谢赞美神的话语。
Thanks be to God for His word.
下面我们一起唱诗歌奇异恩典。
Let's now sing together Amazing Grace.
Thank you.
刘成牧师带领我们祷告。
Please remain standing as we invite Pastor Tim to come and give us the opening prayer.
Let's pray together. Our great God and Heavenly Father, we gather here before you today to thank you as we remember the life of our dear brother Stephen Bass. We thank you for each person who's gathered here today, whose life has been touched by his. We thank you for his blessed life that he lived with us. We thank you for the difference he made in our life, both great and small. We thank you that he was part of our family and that we were part of his. We thank you for the joy of his life, for his generosity, for his kindness and compassion for all. And we thank you today as we celebrate the completion of his life's journey and for his new home with you in heaven. We thank you for the blessed life and the time that we had together with him. And Father, now as we say our final farewell to Steve, we ask that you would comfort each family member and friend. May they turn to you for strength, Lord, knowing that you are our strength and our refuge. You are our help in times of trouble. Lord, you are our peace, even in the midst of grief. We pray that you lift our eyes from the shadows of this earth and to help us to see in the light of eternity in you today. We thank you that you tell us that you are close to us when we are brokenhearted, that your unfailing love for us never ends, and your mercies are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness to us, O Lord. And we thank you, Father, that in the days to come, that you will be with the family, that you will strengthen, sustain, and comfort them as they remember Steve. And we pray that in the days ahead, we can cast our eyes on you and to find your peace and your grace. So we give you this time, and we ask that you be glorified in our midst. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Please be seated. Next is our time of remembrance and eulogy. I'd like to invite Steve's cousin up first. Steve Bass.
Good afternoon. As I mentioned, I am Steve Bass's cousin.
大家下午好，我是 Steve Bass 的cousin， 表兄弟。
I want to personally thank this church and all the members of this church on behalf of the Bass family for all that they have done and are being done and will continue to do for Steve and for his wife May May.
感谢 Steve Bass 的这个教，我代表 Steve Bass 的 family 来感谢这个教会，在这个过程当中，他们为 Steve Bass 的家人，他们的周围的朋友所做的一切。
Also, want to thank everyone who came out today on behalf of Steve Bass's celebration, because we're celebrating his life.And all of the memories that he made.
也感谢今天所有来参加纪念 Steve Bass 的所有的人，我们一起来庆祝，庆祝他的一生。
One of the many things that Steve and I had in common over our lifetime is we inherited a good name on our family tree.
我和 Steve Bass 有共同的一点，就是我们有。都遗传了一个很好的名字，就是 Steve Bass 这个名字，这个家族的名字。
All the way back to our grandfather Jesse Lindsay Bass and his wife, they passed down to us a good name.
我们的祖先把他们的那个好的名字遗传到我们这一代。
They were honest, hardworking, family first, and Christian.Was very important to them.
他们都是有很好的家庭观念，还有基督是他们的最主要的一个信仰。
Along with the good name, Steve's father and mother, Uncle Albert and Aunt Gertrude, and my parents were also more than brothers. They were great friends.
我的父亲和 Steve 的父亲，他们不但只是亲戚，但是他们还是更好最好的朋友。
Uncle Albert and Aunt Gertrude and my father Leonard Bass, mother, they all passed us down good names to follow.
Steve Bass 的父母还有我的父母，他们都把很好的名字遗传到我们这一代。
Just a really neat memory I'd like to share with you that really stood out and still stands out to me today. I want to share with you about Steve and his family.
今天我想跟大家分享一下 Steve Bass 和我们家的一些美好的记忆。
My family would come down to Portsmouth every summer. We lived in Roanoke, and we would spend an entire week with Steve's family.And in the process, my sisters and I developed a very close bond with Steve and his family.
每年我们都会在我们住在 Roanoke， 我们都会在 Portsmouth 度过一周的时间和 Steve Bass 的那个一家人。所以呢，我和我的姐妹呢，就跟 Steve Bass 的那个他们的小孩子，他的兄弟们呢，都建立了很好的关系。
We like most every other children would spend a lot of time eating good because Steve's mother was a great cook. And then we would spend the rest of our days playing together and just having fun.
就像我们小孩一样，我们喜欢吃好的食物。然后呢 ，Steve Bass 的妈妈是一个很好的、很会煮菜，所以呢，我们花了很多时间在一起吃，而且呢，我们也在一起有很多美好的时间一起玩耍。
Back to one of my main points today.
我今天想要讲最主要的一点
is having a good name is important according to a wise king in the Bible named Solomon.
就像在圣经里面的一个名字 Solomon， 我们有一个很好的名字。
Solomon wrote Ecclesiastes 7:1-2.
他这里quote 了一个 Solomon 的一段经文。
A good name is better than expensive perfume.
好的名字比那个香水要更好。
And the day of death is better than the day of birth.
死的那个日子是比生的日子要好。
It is better to go to the house of mourning.
最好是在早上去一个房子。
Than to the house of feasting.
比去一个feasting house 也好。
For death is the destiny of everyone.
因为死亡是每一个人的一个最终目标。
Again, Steve had a good name and he was a good person.
再强调一次，就是说 Steve 他有一个很好的名字。
There is something else. That's very important in life.
在生命当中，生活当中有另外一件事更加也很重要。
Each one of us should see our need of needing a savior.
他看到我们生活当中有需要的。
Not just to see the need, but accept Jesus Christ as our savior.
不单他知道有这个需要，而且他接受耶稣是作为他的救主。
As verified in the scriptures, John 3:16-18.
约翰福音第三章十六到十八节。
For God so loved the world,
神爱世人，
that he gave his only son,
甚至派他的独生子，
that whoever believes on him,
信他的，
shall not perish,
不至灭亡。
But have eternal life.
反得永生。
For God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world.
神没有派他的儿子到这个世界来谴责这个世界。
But the world through Him would be saved.
但这个世界通过他得到了救赎。
Whoever believes in Jesus Christ is not condemned.
任何相信基督的人都不会被诅咒。
But whoever does not believe in Jesus stands condemned already.
但是任何不相信基督的就会被诅咒。
I can stand before you today confident in my conversations with Steve and watching his life that Steve accepted Jesus Christ as his personal Savior.
我站在你的面前很自信地说, Steve 他接受耶稣作为他的救主。
With that being said,
这样说来,
about a year and a half ago, Steve, Mei Mei, and Steve's sister Ann surprised me with a visit at my church in Roanoke one Sunday.
大概一年半以前, Steve, Mei Mei, 还有他的sister, 那个一个比较意外的来到我的教会，在罗马的教会来拜访我们，在一年半以前。
I was not only surprised, but it felt good to see Steve. We were able to worship together and celebrate Jesus together.
我不单只是比较意外，我还很高兴他们来，我们一起来崇拜，还有一起来庆祝耶稣的给我们带来的救赎。
My wife and I took them out for lunch that day, and then we went to my home in Salem.
我们在外面吃了午饭，然后呢，我们请他们到我们家来聚旧。
At my home, we got called up because Steve and I had not seen each other for about 30 years. We were able to talk about memories and had a great time.
在我们家中，我们因为有20多年没有见了，差不多30年。 所以呢,
the one reality in life is that we're all appointed, obviously, a day that we're born, but we're also appointed a day that we're going to die.
生命的意义实际上就是说,
in John chapter 11, it tells a story of one of Jesus' dear friends who had died and was buried.
在约翰福音十一章讲了一个故事，就是耶稣的一个很好的朋友死了，他被埋葬。Jesus
had come to see and to pay his respects.
耶稣去看他。Upon
arriving there,
当他去到那个地方的时候，
Lazarus' sister Martha meets him.
拉索的他的姐姐去看他。
She comes up immediately to Jesus and says, hey, if you would have been here, my brother would still be living.
他说如果你在他死之前来的话，他可能还不至于死亡。
So Jesus asked her a question.
所以耶稣就问他一个问题。
The question was, do you believe your brother Lazarus will rise again?
他说你相不相信你的弟兄Lazarus 会复活。
Martha, like many of us, did not comprehend or realize that she was in the presence of the Messiah.
这个妇女，她就不知道，不清楚这个救世主在她面前的作用。
She was in the presence of God.
她实际上在神的面前。
And so Jesus continues the conversation with Martha.
所以呢，耶稣就继续和Martha来继续来对话。
In verse 26 of that chapter,
在26节，这一章的26节上这样说，
He asked Martha a question.
他问了Martha一个问题。
Again, do you believe your brother will rise again?
他说：“你真的相不相信你的兄弟会复活？”
Martha's answer was, "Yes, Lord."
他说：“当然了，会的。”
I believe that you're not only the Messiah, but you are the Son of God.
他说：“我不但相信你是救世主，你还是神的儿子。”
Jesus is asking every one of us the same question today.
耶稣今天问我们所有在座人的同样的问题。
Do we believe that we will live again?
我们相不相信我们会有复活，会有重生？
Jesus continues the conversation.
耶稣继续这个他们的那个对话。
And he says he makes a bold statement that day.
那他说他那天做了一个很勇敢的那个陈述。
He said, I am the resurrection and the life.
他说我是生命的复活的主。
And whoever believes in me will not die, but live forever.
任何相信的我的人不至死亡，反得永生。
Which made me ponder a personal question for myself.
就让我很深沉思这个问题，思想这个问题。
When I reach my destination of dying or the rapture, and I'm standing at the pearly gates.
所以当我要死亡的时候，当这个死亡来临的时候。
And the angel of the Lord asked me a question. What authority are you here, Jesse Bass?
你有什么权利站在这里呢？我是那个有一个代表上帝的天使问我。
I won't be there because I have a good name only.
我到这里来不是因为我有好的名字。
I won't be there because I lived a good life only.
我到这里来并不是因为我有一个很好的我的一生。
My response will simply be, I am here because the man on the middle cross said I could come.
我在这里的原因就是因为在十字架上的人说我可以到这里来。
Lastly today, I want to read a Nansemond poem, and Sam Bass and I together decided we would come up with a plaque that had a picture of Steve Bass.
Well, Steve Bass 的兄弟 Sam 和我决定写一段东西在他的那个照片上面，在 Steve Bass 的照片上面。
With the Nansemond logo on the bottom.
是他那个印第安部落的他的那个logo 在上面，在下面，在照片的下面。
Because I want to, at the end of reading it, I want to present the plaque to May May, because Steve Bass was a very proud Nansemond Indian.
在我念完这个以后呢，我会把这个 plaque 就是这块匾，我会交给妹妹。因为 Steve Bass 他是一个为他是一个印第安部落的人非常自豪。
So every time she sees the plaque, she'll not only think of Steve, her husband, but the heritage that he left.
所以每一次当妹妹看见这个匾的时候呢，她就会想起Steve Bass， 还有想起他的所继承的印第安部落的这个民族。
I'm going to ask if everyone would stand in honor of Steve Bass and the Nansemond Indians.
请大家站起来，我们来感谢这个印第安部落还有 Steve Bass.
The poem reads, I am a Nansemond. I am a Nansemond. I walk tall and I walk proud. I am an American Indian, but other names I have been called.I am an Nansemond. I am true to my country and my God. And what I've gotten in life, I earned it. Honest and hard. I stood by while the white man in battle, and I shared in his fear and his tears. I am an Nansemond, an American Indian, and I go back in history many years.I am a Nansemond, and I won't hang my head in shame. I'll hold it high, and I'll walk tall. And I will always be proud of my name. I am an American Indian. Let's pray. Father, I thank you for Steve and I and the entire Bass family, our heritage. I thank you for the name.The good name that you have given to us, and that we've tried to live our lives living out that. Lord, I pray today that you would be with Steve's wife, Maymay. Lord, that you would not only comfort her, but you would just surround her with your presence. And I pray, Lord, that you would just send many, many family and friends to her on a regular basis to remind her that she is loved, that she and Steve were greatly loved. And we will continue to love them. Because, Lord, we know that your love that comes from above is eternal love. And we commit to do that in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen. Amen. You may be seated.
Good afternoon. My name is Dachi Powers, Steve's sister-in-law. Our beloved Steve was not only a kind friend to everyone he knew, but also a dependable husband to my sister, a trustworthy brother-in-law to Richard and me, and a popular great uncle to my grandchildren. No matter how busy things got, he always made time for people he cared about and showed us that family comes first. His sudden departure without saying goodbye was a heartbreaking event. It is near impossible for us to live with the fact that he will be absent from our life from now on. However, by God's grace, seeing him go so peacefully, knowing that he had nestled in the arms of God, there was comfort to be found.
亲爱的妹妹，请节哀，愿你在过往的十一年幸福的婚姻点滴的回忆中找到安慰。相信老师，你在天使的歌声中，上帝的荣光里得到永恒的喜悦与平静。Dear
妹妹, in this time of sorrow, may you find comfort in the memories of your happy marriage. Surely Steve had found eternal joy and peace in the glory of God in heaven. May he rest in peace. 谢谢大家。Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Yun, Uncle Steve and Dahu's Meimei's niece. On behalf of my aunt's family members in China who couldn't be here today, I will read a letter that they wrote to Uncle Steve. I'll be reading it in Chinese and then English. 各位来宾大家好，我是大和女士的侄女高云。我将代表我姨妈不能到场的兄弟姐妹念一封他们写给老史的信，我会先用中文再用英文。亲爱的史蒂夫，或许你忽然离去的那一刻，仿佛世间停止了喧嚣。 令遥远的我们猝不及防，难以置信并扼腕痛惜。感恩上帝，在远隔万水千山、东西两个文明国度的茫茫人海中，家族里最小的妹妹阿石与你结缘，成为相互依靠、守护一生的夫与妻。与此同时，你也成为了我们这个大家族兄弟姐妹中的一员。你曾远跨重洋来到我们中间，用你的真挚友善与纯良之心感动每一个人。 温暖那些短暂相聚的欢愉日子，带走了我们的牵挂，留下彼此珍贵的怀念。 此时此刻，让我们和你挚爱的阿什一同，依然用无尽的爱陪伴你。愿你的善与爱之灵魂在上帝的庇护下得以安息，永远怀念你的爱你的兄弟姐妹。 Dear Steve, the moment we heard of your sudden departure, it was as though the world has gone quiet. We were caught completely off guard, in disbelief and sighing in pain. Thankful for God's divine arrangement, our youngest sister, Mei Mei, was able to find love and take her hand in marriage.Despite the vast ocean that existed between you. And you have long become a cherished member of our big loving family. We're thankful for the wonderful times we spent in each other's company. You once traveled across the ocean to be among us. We were deeply touched by your sincerity, your honesty and compassion. Your presence had brought warmth to those happy days of reunion,and had left behind precious memories for all of us. At this moment, let our thoughts and prayers and endless love accompany you in heaven. May your kind soul rest in peace under God's eternal protection. You're forever being missed. Love, your brothers and sisters.
Seem like Steve is gone.
I can still see him. Sorry. I'm here. I'm here. Steve 好像没有离开，还没有离开我们。
I can still see him standing before me, a smile on his face and a gleam in his eye.
我好像还看见他站在我面前，微笑着，眼中发出了快乐的目光。
Telling me how much he liked my peanut butter cookies because I made them for him.
告诉我他有多喜欢我的那个花生酱饼干，因为是我给他做的。
The only thing Steve liked better than receiving a gift from the heart was giving back to others.
只有一样东西，Steve 会比人家从心里面给他的礼物更重要的，就是说他把他所有给予别人。
Whether he was giving others a drink or hauling away trash at a church potluck,
无论是在教会聚餐的时候，他给别人倒饮料，或者是他把垃圾拉走，
or helping trim trees and clear brush at a church field day,
或者是在教会的清洁日，他帮助修剪这个树枝和这个灌木丛，
or helping fix up somebody's house so they can move.
或者是帮助别人来修理他那个房子，所以他们能搬走。
Or giving away fresh vegetables he grew in his garden.
或者是把他在花园里面种植的新鲜蔬菜送给别人。
Or offering to say grace at a friendly gathering.
或者是在有人好人聚餐的时候，他给出这个谢感谢祷告。
Steve was there for you and me.
Steve 他在我们中间，为了我们，他一直在我们中间。
Steve loved who and what he loved.
Steve 爱他的人和事。
He was proud to share his views with everyone.
他很自豪的来和任何人分享他的世界观。
Steve loved God.
Steve 爱神。
Steve often brought little Chinese children whose parents were working long hours at family restaurants to Sunday school and vacation Bible school.
Steve 经常会把他那些父母在餐馆里面做长时间工作的那个中国的小孩子们带去主日学或者是圣经的暑期圣经学校。
Steve and his wife Daha loved little children and wanted them to love Jesus like he loved Jesus.
Steve 和他的太太很爱孩子们，也希望孩子们能像他们一样爱耶稣。
Steve loved his country, the United States of America.
Steve 热爱这个国家，美利坚合众国。
The proudest I've ever seen him was after his wife passed her U.S. citizenship test.
在我看到他最自豪的时刻，就是当他的太太通过了美国公民的这个考试。
He loved his favorite president, Donald Trump.
他爱他喜欢的美国总统 Donald Trump.
And his favorite businessman, Elon Musk.
还有他喜爱的商人 Elon Musk.
In that order.
在这个 order， 在这个顺序，就第一是川普，第二是马斯克。
You could not ask for a more loyal citizen or voter than Steve.
你不会再有一个比 Steve 更忠诚的公民和选民。
Steve loved his tribe.
Steve 爱他的部落。
He frequently offered his views on opportunities for tribal growth and prosperity, and he invited all of his friends to powwow.
他常常抓住机会去给予他对这个部落发展和成长的这个观点，还有他经常请朋友去参加这个powwow， 就是他这个印第安部落经常举的这个聚会。
I remember seeing all the many arts and crafts at powwows.
我常常看见在这个聚会里面所展示的艺术品。
And being impressed by the prominence of the Bass family name on handmade woodwork.
非常的有深刻印象，就是说很多木做的这些工艺品当中呢，有那个 Steve Bass 这个名字，他们家族的名字在上面。
Steve was proud of being one of the Bass boys growing up in Portsmouth.
他也是一个很自豪的在 Bass 这个家族的孩子们的其中一个，他在 Portsmouth 长大。
And later going to work in the nearby naval shipyard where he was an expert shipboard builder.
后来他就在附近的这个海军的造船厂上面工作，他是一名熟练的焊工。
Steve loved his neighbors.
Steve 爱他的邻居。
He frequently gave rides, delivered.
他常常接送给周围的邻居负责接送。
Delivered food.
给他们送食物。
And ran errands for his neighbors.
还有帮他们当跑腿。
Such as the man up the street who lost his legs to diabetes.
就好像在这。他的那条街上的一个男士，他因为糖尿病失去了双腿。
And his wife who later lost her husband.
还有他死了以后还继续照顾他的太太。
Steve loved his family.
Steve 爱他的家人，他的家人。
Even after he was diagnosed with kidney cancer.
尽管在他被诊断得了肾癌以后。
Steve called or texted church family and asked them to pray for his wife.
Steve 还继续的打电话，还有或者是短信，这个教会的弟兄姐妹们。
Who was having bad pain?
要他们为他的太太祷告，因为他太太有很严重的背疼。
Steve also loved his wife's daughter Yi like she was his own.
Steve 也很爱他太太的女儿 Yi， 就好像爱他自己亲生的女儿一样。
He helped his wife to complete the paperwork needed for Yi to get her U.S. immigrant visa.
他帮助Yi 来完成一切要美国移民签证所需要一些文件，帮他都填好了。
And he was just as upset as his wife for the long wait.
他也跟他的太太一样的同样的沮丧和失望，就是要等很长时间还没有批下来。
Steve loved his friends.
Steve 爱他的朋友。
I will close with a Bible verse and a funny story that captures Steve's spirit.
我会用下面的两段来做结束。一个就是我要 quote 一个要选一段经文，圣经上的一段经文，还有呢讲一个有趣的故事。
First, the Bible verse.
首先是圣经上的经文。
Luke 3:11 says.
路加福音十一章。路加福音第三章十一节这样说。
John the Baptist answered.
约翰受洗约翰这样回答说。
Anyone who has two shirts should share with the one who has none.
你有两件衬衣的，就分一件给别人。
And anyone who has food should do the same.
有食物的也要同样做。
I ask.
我问。
How many of you here have received a shirt or a bundle of food from Steve?
你们当中有没有谁接受过 Steve 的那个衣服还有食物的呢？举起手来。
Second.
下面。
I see almost everybody. a funny story.
下面就讲一个有趣的故事。
I told Steve I like to eat rabbit.
我告诉 Steve 我喜欢吃兔子。
He asked me,
had I 问我
had I ever tried squirrel?
你有没有尝试过吃松鼠？
I said, no.
我说没有。
He said, would you like me to bring you one?
我说你要不要我帮你拿一只过来？
Being confident that Steve could not deliver on his offer, I said, sure.
因为我很相信 Steve 不可能抓到一只松鼠，我说 OK。
Little did I know that he would enlist the help of his two best friends.
我谁知呢？他把他的最好的两个朋友来要帮他的忙。
Smith and Wesson.
Smith and Wesson 和 Wesson 两个他的好兄弟。
To shoot a squirrel who was eating carrots from his garden.
把一只在他的后园正在吃那个红萝卜的那个松鼠被打，打死，然后把它放到这个冰柜里面。
Olmec, his wife Daha found it first and tossed it out.
谁知呢？他的太太美美的发现了在冰柜里面的这个松鼠，就把它扔掉。
He was upset.
然后呢 ，Steve 就很这个沮丧。
He said that was a gift for Rod.
他说这是给Rod 的那个礼物。
But being the good friend that he was,
但是作为一个好朋友
，He went out and shot another one.
他又去打死了一只松鼠。
And delivered it to me the following Sunday.
然后呢，在下一个星期天呢，他就拿到教会去给我。
My wife Lee.
我的太太 Lee.
Turned red when she saw it.
当她看到这个松鼠以后，她脸就变红了。
I must confess now, I never ate it.
我必须要坦白，我没有吃。
But I will always love you for it, my good friend Steve.
但是我永远爱你，我的好朋友Steve.
在6月28号，我接到林牧师的庄重通知，他在追悼仪式上赋予我一项崇高的使命。
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters and friends. On June 28th, Pastor Echo invited me to share about the impact of our dearly loved Steve.
那就是在四分钟之内，以今天的语言向我们共同敬仰和爱戴的史蒂夫表达无尽的哀思。
And share with them how much we loved him.
6月22日凌晨，我们无法预见的悲剧降临。
Early in the morning on June 22nd,
我们挚爱的兄长史蒂夫突然离世。
Our beloved brother Steve suddenly and unexpectedly departed from the earth.
这无疑是一次震撼心灵的打击。
Leaving us all in shock and sorrow.
令我们所有人都深感震惊。
We are all confronted with a stark reality.
然而，现实无情地揭示，他已经倾尽生命的最后一滴血，耗尽所有的力量。
That he had already expended all his strength.
如同蜡炬成灰，与我们永别。
And like a candle that had burned out, he finally bid us farewell.
史蒂夫，他是一个全心全意爱上帝的基督教徒。
Steve was a Christian who dearly loved God.
无论在教堂、在家庭和社区，他都是一位全力以赴的奉献领袖。
He was a dedicated leader in his church, family, and community.
我们每一位在场的人都曾被他的温暖的微笑、友善的举止和无私的帮助所感染。
All of us who knew him were moved by his warm smile, friendliness, and selflessness.
他如同黑暗中的一缕光芒，柔和地照亮着我们内心的每一个角落。
He was like a light shining in the darkness to warm our hearts.
就在他离世的前一天，他还在忙碌帮助邻里， 而当消息传来
Even the day before his passing, he was busy helping his neighbors.
我们看到邻居的在自家门前轮椅上痛哭失声，哇哇大哭。
And when we heard the sad news about Steve, we were also deeply moved to see Steve's neighbor sitting in his wheelchair in front of his house, crying and weeping.
那一幕深深地触动了我们每一个人的心灵深处。
Which also expressed our sorrow as well.
史蒂夫的仁慈如同基督的爱，充满了宽恕与关怀。
Steve had the love of Christ.
无论顺境还是逆境，他都以微笑面对，坦然接受生活的安排。
He faced both good and bad times with a smile.
他的每一次行动，每一次伸出援手，都深深地烙印着基督般的深沉之爱。
Each time he reached out to help was imprinted with the deep love of Christ.
他的生活本身就是一部活生生的圣经，诉说着爱的奇迹。
He lived out the Bible's miracle of love.
他的坚持与善意将在我们心中永恒不朽。
And we will never forget his spirit of kindness.
我今日有幸在此分享我的感慨。
So today I'm happy and honored to be able to share my thoughts.
是史蒂夫和他深爱的爱妻大河，他称她为美美。
It was because of Steve and his love for his wife that he called Mei Mei.
是他们引导我步入了基督的圣殿。
It was them who brought me into the temple of Christ.
让我找到了生命的终极目标。
So that I could find my ultimate purpose in life.
也是他们促成了我与约翰在美国的相识、相知、相爱。
And it was them who helped me meet in person my love.
共同建立了我们的温馨家园
so that John and I could establish our own home together.
回忆初到之时，面对语言的困境和陌生的环境。
When I first arrived to the U.S., I faced everything was new to me, including the language, and everything was strange and unusual.
他们如同天使，无数次的往返于普兹茅斯与弗吉尼亚海滩。
But Steve and Daho, like angels, repeatedly traveled back and forth between Portsmouth and Virginia Beach.
陪我考取驾照，寻找房源，购买家居产品。
To help me to be able to get my driver's license and buy a house and furniture.
他们这些年一如既往的帮助和鼓励我在创业之路上充满了活力。
And they really moved me deeply so that I really wanted to thank them.
也激发了我不断前行的信心。
And grew my faith.
我暗自立誓要为他们争光，不辜负他们的期望，这是我能给予他们最高的敬意。
So I secretly vowed to honor them and not let them down.This tribute is the highest respect I can give them.
如今，史蒂夫的笑容和声音在记忆中回荡。
So today, Steve's smile and his voice still echoes in our minds.
每一次拥抱，他的笑容如同冬日阳光。
His hugs and his smiles were like the sun in the winter.
他的每一次关怀犹如老友的深情问候。
And his care was like an old friend, always asking after us.
他会说，你和约翰都好吗？我们都爱你们。
He would ask me, are you and John doing well? We love you.
这不是简单的问候，而是他内心的祝福和深情，如同基督的爱，无边且无私。
This seemingly simple greeting was his heartfelt expression of blessing and affection, like the love of Christ.Limitless and selfless.
他的离世让我们悲痛，但他的精神与爱将如天堂的云朵涌入我们心中。
Although we're all saddened by his departure, Steve's spirit and love will remain in our hearts like the clouds of heaven.
此刻，让我们在心中默念祈祷，祈愿他的灵魂 安息在天堂的怀抱。
Our prayer is that his soul rest in the bosom of heaven.
让我们的思念化作无声的祝福，他的爱如同影子，永远伴随坚强的大和解和我们前行，并仰望祈求圣灵使大和解和女儿尽快团聚。
That our memories of him will be a blessing, and that his love, like our own shadow, will always accompany and strengthen both Da He and the rest of us. We pray that the Holy Spirit will reunite Da He and their daughter one day.
一切荣耀归于赞美于主。
To God be the glory and praise.
谢谢大家。
Thank you. Dear friends and guests,
今天我们一同聚集在上帝的面前，纪念 Steve 的生平和属灵遗产。
We gather today before God to commemorate the life and spiritual legacy of Steve Bass.
在过去几周艰难的时间里面
，Over these past several difficult weeks,
我看到教会内外的朋友们和弟兄姊妹们对 Steve 的离去所表达出来的深切的思念和哀悼。
I've witnessed the great sorrow of Steve's friends from both within and outside of the church over his passing.
还有对大和的爱和关怀
and the love for 大和
真实的见证了 Steve 的生命深深地影响了我们
which expressed how deeply Steve has impacted each of us.
他的离开牵动了我们所有人的心
and his departure has moved each one of us.
Steve 是一个爱妻子、爱家人、爱朋友、爱教会爱小朋友、爱国家，更是一个爱主的人。
Steve was a man who loved his wife, family, friends, church, children, country, and even more his God.
我们人生当中许多时候的道别是很艰难的。
Often in life, it's so difficult to say goodbye.
尤其像这样的道别。
Especially this kind of goodbye.
Steve 在没有任何预兆的情形下离开我们。
The suddenness with which Steve left us.
更加是艰难的
makes it even more difficult.
所以我看到今天有这么多的人在雨中在这样的天气当中来参加 Steve 的追思礼拜
When I see so many of you here gathered to commemorate Steve on such a day
我个人尤其感谢今天所有来参加追思礼拜的来宾
I'm so thankful for each of you to come here
这个时候来支持大和还有家人
to support Da He and their family
这是对 Steve 生命最大的肯定。
This is the greatest testimony for Steve's life.
我想到太多时候死亡来得太突然了。
So often death comes so too soon.
太早了。
Before we are ready for it.
但是都在神的掌控当中。
But it is all within the control of God.
我们对 Steve 的突然离世都感到意外和震惊。
We're all so surprised and shocked by Steve's passing.
但是神没有。
But God was not.
神不惊讶。
God was not surprised.
Steve 此刻就享受在与上帝同在的喜乐当中。
Steve now is enjoying the presence and the joy of God's presence.
在诗篇九十一篇，神的话语说：“住在至高者隐秘处的，必住在全能者的荫下。”我要论到耶和华说，他是我的避难所，是我的山寨，是我的神，是我所倚靠的。他必救你脱离捕鸟人的网罗和毒害的瘟疫。他必用自己的翎毛遮蔽你，你要投靠在他翅膀底下。他的诚实是大小的盾牌。
Psalm 91 verses 1 through 4 says, Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty.I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and your rampart.
So, 有一个问题都摆在我们众人面前。
Now there's a question before us all.
当我们生活中经历像这样悲伤难过的日子的时候
When we encounter painfully difficult times like this
你去哪里寻找真正的平安和避难所
Where do you turn to get peace and a refuge
有没有一个人可以在这样的日子当中，当你内心经历巨大的创伤、失去的时候，可以来安慰你？
Is there anyone who can really give you the comfort in the midst of such turmoil?
遮蔽你，保护你。
Who can shield you and protect you?
在这样的日子里面，只有一个避难所存在。
On this day, there's only one who can really be your refuge.
在我们失去一位弟兄、妻子、失去丈夫、兄弟姐妹、失去亲人的时候，
When we've lost our brother or wife loses her husband, or a sibling loses a family member,
只有一个地方你可以找到真正的平安和力量。
There's only one place where you can really find peace and strength.
就是在全能者的荫下。
Which is in the shadow of the Almighty.
在上帝翅膀的荫下。
Under the shadow of God's wings.
保罗他也这样说，在罗马书八章三十一节说，即使这样，还有什么说的呢？神若帮助我们，谁能抵挡我们呢？
Paul said in Romans 8:31, What then shall we say in response to these things? If God is for us, who can stand against us?
所以使徒保罗知道答案。
So Paul knew the answer.
没有人可以抵挡我们。
There is no one who can stand against us.
死亡也不能。
Not even death.
所以保罗就好像诗人一样，对神表达出巨大的信心和盼望。
Paul, just like the psalmist, expressed deep faith and hope in God.
他们都告诉我们，我们的盼望在乎神。
They each told us that our real hope is in God.
不可否认的是，诗篇的作者在生活当中观察到看到许多的艰难和困苦。
We can't deny that the psalmist observed and experienced much pain and suffering.
但是他的心思意念没有被这些威胁、问题、生活里面的头疼和挣扎所捆绑住。
But their spirits were not held captive by these dangers, problems, troubles, or struggles.
相反的，他把信心放在至高者所给予的安全和安慰上。
Rather, they put their faith in the peace and comfort given by the Most High God.
避难所和天堂在人间是找不到的。
A true refuge and paradise cannot be found here on this earth.
只有在至高者的荫下。
Only under the shadow of the Most High.
我们自己所做的从来都不能带给我们长久的平安和保障。
We on our own are not able to create a lasting peace or security.
平安和喜乐只能在基督里面找到。
Peace and happiness can only be found in Christ.
诗人描述了一幅温馨的场景，上帝保护我们，就好像鸟妈妈伸出自己的翅膀，遮盖住小鸟。
The psalmist described a warm scene where God's protection over us is like a mother bird who spreads her wings to shield her babies.
一幅温暖平安的画面。
It's a warm and peaceful picture.
神对我们的保护是时时刻刻。
God's protection of us is continual.
就好像母鸡保护小鸡一样
，like a mother hen protecting her baby chicks，
在一切想要打垮我们、打击我们的事上
，whenever anything wants to come and knock us down or attack us，
上帝是我们的拯救
，God is our savior。
所以在这个今天忧伤失落的日子里
，on this day of sorrow，
神在他儿子耶稣基督的复活上给我们每一个人都有盼望。
God gives us each hope through His Son Jesus Christ and His resurrection.
他教导我们，世界不是我们心灵最终安息的地方。
He teaches us that the world is not our final resting place.
对于那些选择跟随耶稣的人，神已经应许了永生。
For those who choose to follow Jesus, God promises eternal life.
约翰福音十一章二十五节，耶稣就对他们说。复活在我，生命也在我。信我的人虽然死了，也必复活。凡活着信我的人，必永远不死。
John 11 verses 25 and 26 says, Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die. And whoever lives by believing in me will never die.
约翰福音十四章里面，耶稣也对门徒说，你们心里不要忧愁，你们信神，也当信我。在我父的家里有许多住处，若是没有，我就早已告诉你们了。我去原是为你们预备地方去。我若去为你们预备了地方，就必再来接你们到我那里去。我在哪里，叫你们也在哪里。我往哪里去，你们知道，那条路你们也知道。
John 14, 1 through 4 says, Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I'm going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you may also be where I am. You know the way to the place where I'm going.
耶稣叫我们在患难中相信他的平安。
Jesus calls us to trust in his peace when we're in the midst of turmoil.
当耶稣进入耶路撒冷的那个星期,
the week of Jesus' triumphal entry to Jerusalem,
门徒看到的是一个荣耀的耶稣。
The disciples saw a glorified Jesus.
他走在棕树枝铺的路上。
He walked on a road lined with palm branches.
但是很快耶稣就告诉他们说, 我跟你们不会很在一起，不会很久的。
But Jesus quickly told them, I will not be with you much longer.
所以门徒们都非常的伤心。
So the disciples were very upset.
耶稣告诉他们说, 你们心里不要忧愁。
Jesus said, don't worry.
你们的心要停止忧愁。
Stop your worrying.
门徒听到说耶稣要离开了。
When the disciples heard that Jesus was going to leave them,
他们的心就破碎瓦解了。
Their hearts were shattered.
耶稣跟他们说, 你们既然相信上帝那位看不见的上帝，这个时候你们就要相信我。
Jesus said, since you believe in God whom you cannot see, you must now also believe in me.
虽然我很快就会离开你们。Though
I'm about to depart from you.
在忧伤当中，唯一可以找到平安的方法就是相信耶稣。
In the midst of brokenheartedness, the only way to find peace is to believe in Jesus.
当耶稣听到拉撒路死了。
When Jesus had heard that Lazarus had died,
他也哭了,
he also cried.
他的心也碎了,
and his heart was also broken.
耶稣知道这个世界上有苦难,
Jesus understood the bitterness of this world.
他告诉我们在他里面可以寻找平安,
but he told us that we can find peace in him.
他不单单把平安给我们,
not only does he give us peace,
他还吩咐我们要专注在世界之外的另外一个地方。
He also calls us to turn our attention to somewhere other than this earth.
他说我去要为你们预备一个地方。
He said, I'm going to prepare a place for you.
对每一个认识耶稣的人,
for each person who believes in Jesus,
死亡不是一个未知的结局。
Death is not an unknown end.
每个信徒都被保证要去到一个没有忧伤、没有痛苦、再没有扭曲和不公义的地方。
Every believer is promised that they will go to a place where there is no more sorrow, pain, worries, or wickedness. Jesus has prepared eternity for each person who has believed in him. And so we can have assurance that today's death is not the final end. For Christians, the next step is eternal life.
今天我们聚集在这里见证生命的短暂。So
here we're gathered and witnesses of the brevity of life.
同时也提醒我们每一个人要严肃地为将来更大更久的日子做准备。And
we're also reminded of our need to soberly prepare for that even greater day.
亲爱的朋友,
dear brothers and dear friends,
今天你住在我们内中，你相信福音吗？
You who are sitting here, do you believe in the gospel?
我们住在一个千变万化的世界当中。
We are here in an ever-changing world.
没有一样事物是一成不变的。
There's nothing that will not change.
我们的社会在变迁。
Our society is evolving.
朋友在改变。
Our friends are changing.
人生的季节在改变。
Our seasons of life are shifting.
改变是我们自然生命生老病死的一部分。
Change is part of our natural cycle of birth, aging, sickness, and death.
但是福音说我们在基督里面的平安和安慰永不改变。
But the gospel says that our peace and comfort that we have in Christ will never change.
耶稣说复活在我，生命也在我，信我的人虽然死了，也必复活。
Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me will live, even though they die.
耶稣把美好的天堂比喻成天父的家。
Jesus described heaven as his father's house.
我们每一个人都有家。
Each of us has a home.
对于家的概念我们都不陌生。
And we are very familiar with the meaning of home.
家是一个安全可靠躲避风雨的地方。
The home is a place of safety where you can hide from the storms.
家里有父母亲的慈爱呵护。
Home is where your parents love and care for you.
家里你可以诉说委屈。
Home is where you can let out your grievances.
家里你可以享受佳肴。
And you can enjoy the good food.
总之家是一个非常温馨的地方。
Home is an incredibly comforting place.
有人给家下一个这样的定义，他说呢，家是这样一个地方，就是当你到达那里的时候，他们必会把你接进去。
Someone once said, this is what home is. When you get there, they welcome you in.
通往天堂的道路。
The way to heaven.
不是金钱、宗教、善行、功德。
Is not by gold, religion, gold, good deeds, or merit.
通往天堂的道路只有一个人，就是耶稣。
The way to heaven is through a person, which is Jesus.
通往天堂只有一条路。
There's only one way to heaven.
要想获得永生，必须与上帝建立关系。
To attain eternal life, we must develop an intimate relationship with God.
所以主耶稣他自己说，认识你独一的真神，并且认识你所差来的耶稣基督，这就是永生。
Jesus said, now this is eternal life.That they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom they have sent.
Steve 在去世前的一周，他还来到我们教会当中。
Steve was among us at church just the week before his passing.
那个周末是父亲节。
And that weekend was the Father's Day.
我们教会父亲节的周末，我们教会有 church picnic.
And that weekend we had a church picnic.
Steve 就来到我们当中享受基督的团契。
So he was among us fellowshipping with us.
然后在父亲节当天
And on Father's Day Sunday
是主日崇拜
It was a day of worship.
Steve 和大和来参加主日聚会
And 大和 and Steve were both at our church worshipping.
在 Steve 去世了之后，我就从阅读大家的留言当中知道。
And after Steve passed away, when I read all the messages that you left,
那天教会里面的孩子们专门给 Steve 做了父亲节的卡片。
I discovered that the children at church had written Father's Day cards for Steve.
Steve 有爱孩子的恩赐。
Steve had the gift of love for children.
他很疼爱教会里面的小朋友。
He truly loved the children within the church.
他就像好像刚刚的弟兄分享到的，他爱张毅就好像爱自己的女儿一样。
Just as was shared earlier, he loved his stepdaughter just as if she were his own daughter.
所以我收到张毅他给 Steve 写的一段的卡片的 message.
And so I also received a card written by his, 张毅.
I'm going to read English and then I will translate into Mandarin. 张毅 said, Steve, I know you like sunflowers. They are sunny, bright, and open. And they still bloom when they bend down.They are just like you. Steve, we always love you and miss you. Daughter E. 张毅写给他爸爸的信息上，他就说呢， Steve, 我知道你喜欢太阳花向日葵，它们阳光灿烂，打开，并且每当向日葵滴下去的时候，它们还是打开的，它们就像你一样， Steve, 我们永远爱你，思念你。弟兄姐妹， Steve 在基督里面他找到了信仰。
Brothers and sisters, Steve found religion and faith in Jesus Christ.
他因为相信耶稣基督获得了永生。
Because he believed in Jesus Christ, he has eternal life.
他在信仰里面享受自由。
In his faith, he has freedom.
他在基督里面找到了团契。
And within Christ, he found fellowship.
在他走过的72个春秋岁月当中，他的生命当中有耶稣。
Within his 72 years of life, he had Jesus.
亲爱的朋友们，死亡是肯定的。
Brothers and sisters, death is certain.
人人都有一死，死后且有审判。
Each one of us will die one day, and after death is judgment.
死亡会或迟或早地来到我们每一个人的生命当中。
Death will come to each one of us, whether sooner or later.
它可能会突然间地临到。
It may come suddenly.
也有可能在疾病的挣扎徘徊之后临到
or after a long battle with illness
死亡会来到君王的宫殿当中
death will come to the palace of a king
死亡会临到贫穷人的寒舍当中
and death will also come to the sheep of a poor person.
他一定会来到。
But it will come for sure.
唯一的一条路。
The only path.
唯一为死亡做准备的方法就是通过信耶稣。
The only way to truly prepare for death is to believe in Jesus.
你准备好了吗？
Are you prepared?Thank you.
家人和亲友们对 Steve 弟兄的生平变化。
Thank you for each of you who shared your memories and eulogies of Steve.
使我们能够更加的认识我们亲爱的弟兄。
That we could know our beloved brother even better.
我们也非常感谢牧师的林发可牧师的信息。
And we also want to thank Pastor Lin for his sermon.
他们知道我们主耶稣是我们的避难所，是我们的平安，是我们的永生的盼望。
That we would know that Jesus is our only refuge, our only comfort, and our only hope.
下边我们请大家起立，我们一起唱，Closing Hymn。
Let's please stand together and sing What a Friend We Have in Jesus. And we are thankful for Steve's spiritual life.
我们感谢你在今天下午的时光当中，主带领我们一起纪念他的生命。
And today we are thankful for this opportunity to remember his life.
谢谢你所有的工作。
We thank you for all your work.
我们格外的为家人来祷告。
And we also want to pray for his family.
恳求你的医治安慰进入到家人的 心灵里面。
That your healing and your peace would enter into their hearts.
求你保守他们。
May you protect them.
与他们同在。
And be, may your presence be with them.
也盼望你的福音的真理进到今天在场的每一个人心灵里面。
And may the truth of your gospel message enter into each person's heart here.
把荣耀归给你。
And we want to give all glory to you.
当我们今天追思礼拜结束，我们散去的时候，神。求你的平安，求你福音的力量与我们同在。
And we ask that as we depart from this memorial service, that your peace would be with us.
愿主耶稣基督的恩惠。
May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ.
上帝的慈爱。
And the love of God.
圣灵的感动与交通。
The Holy Spirit's peace.
常与众人同在。
Be with each of us.
阿们。请坐。
Please be seated.
好，那我们就下面有一项通知，是 Steve 的家人感谢大家今天的到访，特别邀请亲友在追思礼拜结束后到交易厅一起享用食物和茶水。
The family of Stephen Bass thanks each of you for your attendance today and invites the relatives and friends to join them in the fellowship hall for refreshments after the memorial service.
好，谢谢大家。
Thank you.
交易厅在后边。
The fellowship hall is in the back.